We like to do at this time a ballad about a very beautiful woman. This particular song was written by a man who was very much in love with this woman, as he wrote this next song as a monument and as a dedication towards her, because his love was very strong and he loved her very much, that it was very strong. They wrote this as a monument and as a dedication towards her, because she's so very beautiful and lovely, at evil, wicked, mean, and bad, and nasty inside. And she used to go around shoving him and pushing him around and screaming at him and shoving it at him and stuff. And he didn't care because she was so very beautiful and lovely, at evil, wicked, mean, and bad, and nasty inside. She used to go around shoving him and pushing him around, and he just didn't care. And all the men that saw her just fell in love with her. There's just a bunch of men that didn't even know her, just standing around. She'd just walk down, just walk down the street, and they'd see her, and they'd all fall in love with her.
Yeah, I know that.
Just, they'd just be standing there, and she'd walk down the street, and they'd fall in love with her. She was a streetwalker. They didn't care, because she was so very beautiful and lovely, yet evil, wicked, mean, and bad, and nasty. And prosperous.
All right. That's enough.
Even during the Depression. So he didn't care. Seriously, though, a lot of times, I think in our own personal experiences and through reading books, novels, and movies, and even possibly people we know personally, we've seen great love affairs and great romances between a man and woman, and sometimes we've wondered to ourselves possibly that I don't understand why this guy loves her because she has so many faults, I don't understand, or vice versa. But the true loves, the mature love in the world, are built on the foundation that nobody's perfect in love is, that you adjust to the facts that nobody's perfect in love is very, and the foundation of beauty and strength for mature love is built on the nobody's perfect.
That's beautiful. That's good. Isn't that nice?
She was going around shoving him and pushing him around and kicking him and stuff, and he knew she had a lot of faults. She was psychologically sick and with neurotic and psychosis, and he never once ever deserted her, because his love was very strong, that he spent loving much money and loving care and devotion to this. Shut up. Spent much loving care.
It's about time.
I'll tell you when. Yeah. As he never deserted her, as she was That's psychologically right. sick, and he sent her to all the world's great psychoceramists for help. She worked with Freud
right.
and Jung.
Right.
And her most notable success was with Pavlov. Every time he rang a bell, she was ready.
All right. Cut that out. That's enough.
She couldn't ride trains or trolley cars.
All right.
Ding, 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 ding.
Okay. Tell them the name of her.
You've probably heard her name before, because her name is synonymous with beauty and evilness, and her name's been used for generations to note an evil wickedness, and it's synonymous with beauty and evilness, and it's a licentious name. Possibly have heard this name before when someone in anger, unthinkingly and blatantly said this word in anger in reference to some woman. It's kind of a back alley word.
No,
it's insidious.
You shouldn't say it.
She was called Mary Ann Johnson. And the name of the song is entitled Mary Ann. Gee, you're mean and evil and wicked and bad and nasty and prosperous inside.
All right, fine. Jezebel, it was you, you, you. If ever the devil's plan was made to torment man, it was you, Jezebel, it was you. If ever a pair of eyes promised paradise, it was you, Jezebel, it was you. Like a demon, love possessed me, you obsessed me constantly. What evil star above was to shine above on your love? Jezebel,
your evil,
if
wicked,
ever the devil was born without a pair
around.
Of horns, it was you.
You're horny.
Jezebel.
Pushing and shoving.
If ever a pair of eyes promised paradise, it was you, Jezebel, it was you. Like a demon, love possessed me, you obsessed me constantly. What evil star above was to shine above on your love? Jezebel
and Lolita.
Jezebel.
Betty Crocker.
Jezebel. Jezebel.
Love is a gentle thing, but it only has caused me pain. For the only girl I ever did love, gone on that midnight train, I never will marry. I'll take me no wife. I expect to live single all of my life.
The train pulled out and the whistle blew with a low and a lonesome moan. She's gone, like the midnight dew.
Left me all alone, I never will marry. I'll take me no wife, I expect to live single.
Many a change in the winter wind, and the change in the cloud design. There's many a change in a young girl's heart,
never a change in mine, I never will marry. I'll take me no wife, I expect to live single all of my life.
We'd like to do at this time a song that my brother wrote. This is original song my brother wrote 5 years ago. My brother wrote this song in a fit of creative passion and genius. My brother wrote this song, and we only performed it, my brother and myself, only 3 times. We performed this song 3 times, and it was immediately stolen from us by this other commercial crass. Was stolen from us by this other commercial crass group that stole the song. They never acknowledged.
No, Tommy, don't
they just
go
stole
into
the
that.
Song
no.
from my
Tom,
younger brother.
Don't go into that. It's just embarrassing to say.
They're adults. They're entitled now. They stole this song from
along
my brother,
with my luggage.
Along with his luggage.
Right.
And they put it on one of the major record companies. They never once. And it sold over 3 million records, my brother's song that he wrote, and they never acknowledged it. As a result, it sold over 3 million records, and as a result, pay attention. As a result, every time we've performed my own brother's song that he wrote in his creative effort and genius responsible, every time we've performed his own song, we've been ridiculed.
And persecuted.
We've been ridiculed and persecuted every time we perform this song, that people will come up and say, I heard your show, and you stole that song from that other commercial crass group. You just stole that song. So we're going to ridicule you and prosecute you.
Persecute
you. So I'd like to take this time to set the record straight, as my brother's deprived of the one.
You were right the first time.
He was deprived of this opportunity of having for posterity to understand and enjoy. I'd like to publicly dedicate the performance of this song to my younger brother for his creative effort and genius in writing this song.
You don't have to
I'm
do that.
I'm going to, Dickie. Oh. I'd like to publicly dedicate to you, Dickie Smothers, the creative effort and genius responsible for this song. I'd like to publicly dedicate to you at this time.
Thanks.
Swell.
Thanks a lot.
You're welcome. We'd like to perform it for you now, and I'm sure you've all heard the song many times before, but we'd like to do it for you in the original first time, the first time way
in
the original.
You mean the virgin edition.
The what?
I said, you mean the virgin edition. We'll sing it in the virgin edition.
I don't know what that means.
Oh, come on.
Edition, I don't know what it means.
Edition?
We like to do it's original virgin.
No, just sing it.
Sing it. Ready?
I'm ready.
I knew it'd be ridiculed.
Throughout history, there's been the story of the internal triangle.
This paternal.
Eternal triangle. This particular internal triangle concerned a condemned man named Tom Crudely, a man named Jason, and another man named Sally Jean Johnson.
Hey, now cut that out.
Oh, hang down your head, Tom Crudely.
Poor boy.
Hang down your head and fly. Ha ha ha. Hang down your head. Boy, you're hung. I met her on a mountain.
Poor boy.
Oh, there I took her. Several times. I met her on a mountain. Stabbed her with my knife. Hang your head down. Hang your head down.
Do.
Hang down your head, Tom Crudely.
Poor boy.
Hang down your head and why? Ha ha ha. Hang down your head, Tom Crudely. Poor boy.